Miss Kim has a ladybug on her knee, and she's wearing her big fat red tutu. Yay, this is all about Ladybug Girl. And today, we're going to introduce her very best, almost dropped the ladybug, her very best friend, and his name is Bumblebee. Boy, did you see what I just did? Yes, I was using my jazz hands. Did you bring any jazz hands today? I hope you did, because let's review. This is how we say ladybug. That's right, that's our jazz hand. We're going to make a three sign with our opposable thumb sticking out, and we're going to come and have the bug land on our nose. Ladybug, and then this is girl with, again, our opposable thumb, and we're going to just caress our cheek. Now, how will we say Bumblebee boy? Again, same bug sign. Bumblebee, and then this is boy. It's like you're putting on a baseball cap, right? Bumblebee boy. All right, and again, how do we spell ladybug girl's name? Her name is Lou. Lou, that's L-U-L-U. That's right, that's a pattern of letters, isn't it? Well, without further ado, let's go on ahead and say our greeting of the week. Howdy to all of our friends. And a one, and a two, and a three. Howdy, everybody. Yes. Oh, wrong song. Oopsie-daisies. Let's rewind and start anew. We'll say, howdy, grown-ups. It's so wonderful to see you. Kiddos, we're so happy you joined us. Readers, we're glad you came to read. Yay! Well, producer Nate and I are going to do a little reader theater for you today, friends. So let's bring on over my sidekick. Let's bring over producer Nate. Helper. Extraordinaire. That's right. Oh, what does Mr. Nate have on his head? Producer Nate has a bumblebee hat. Producer Nate has a bumblebee hat. Producer Nate has a bumblebee hat. It has two little antenna. It's so cool.
And
a stinger. Because today, Producer Nate is going to be Bumblebee Boy. And Miss Kim is going to be Ladybug Girl. And they are friends. And they're going to get together and have some fun. So let's introduce our second book in our Ladybug Girl series. And this is Ladybug Girl and Bumblebee Boy. That's right. Did we do story time magic? Oh my goodness. Oopsie-daisies. We almost forgot to let story time magic in the room. So let's do that together. As a team. And a one. And a two. And a three. Let's have our bumblebee do the story time magic. It is story time right now. Yay! Story time. Yay! Story time. Yay! It is story time right now. Yay! Let's read our book. Ladybug Girl and Bumblebee Boy. And again, this is a book by David Soman. He's the author. What does the author do? The author writes the book. The author writes the book. Hi-ho, librario. The author writes the book. And again, the illustrator is Jackie Davis. What does the illustrator do? The illustrator draws the pictures. The illustrator draws the pictures. Hi-ho, librario. The illustrator draws the pictures. So, again, producer Nate is going to be the character how do we do red? That's right. Like you're putting on lipstick for date night. R-E-D, red. R-E-D, red. I can spell red. I can spell red. Ladybug's tutu is so red. Her boots are so red. R-E-D. R-E-D. All right, Ladybug girl. And Bumblebee boy. And again, every time you see the word Ladybug girl in red, go ahead and read it with us. Because we're going to be doing it as a team. Ladybug girl is ready to play, says Lulu. She's been waiting forever to go to her favorite playground, the one with the twisty slide and the bouncy dinosaurs. I wonder if she's going to bring Bingo with her. Do you think she will? Mm-hmm. Dogs love to park. Her mama grabs Bingo's leash and says, all right, let's go. So they are going to bring Bingo with them. And Ladybug Girl leaps over sidewalk cracks that are as big as canyons when she sees Mrs. Robbins carrying her groceries. Ladybug Girl swoops over to help. The bag is heavy as a boulder, but it isn't a problem for Ladybug Girl. And Ladybug Girl can count really high. She counts mailbox after mailbox after mailbox. I wonder how many she counted. All the way up to infinity. Oh my goodness.
I can't count that much.
I know, right? I think you ran out of fingers. Bingo sniffs everything. Because, come on, that's what dogs do. Oh, look at this fabulous playground. Oh my goodness, there is a twisty slide. There's a sandbox. There's a big fort. There's swings. So much fun. When they get to this fabulous playground, it's full of kids. While Bingo settles into his spot under the bench, I bet he likes it because it's so shady and cool. Lulu, L-U, L-U, looks around for someone to play with. She's looking for a friend. Oh, and look who she found. She found her friend, Sam. Ooh, wait a minute. Sam's shirt is Twinkie Twinsies with Nate's hat. Oh, is that a special clue? Do you think maybe Sam is really Bumblebee Boy? Let's find out. She sees her friend, Sam, from her music class. He's playing by himself in the sandbox. And fun fact, see this little guy over here? That's his little brother, Owen. We're going to find out about him tomorrow with our next book in the series, The Amazing Adventures of Bumblebee Boy. Hi, Sam, says Lulu.
Hi, Lulu,
he says back.
Want to play with me?
Sure, but what do you want to play? Asks Lulu.
Diggers, of course.
Lulu has never really liked playing diggers. She doesn't like getting sand in her boots. How about monkeys? She said. why Sam doesn't want to play seesaw with her. You can't really play seesaw with just one person. Right, Nate?
Mm.
That's right. Oh, look at their faces. Do they look happy? No. Do they look excited? No, I think they look pretty frustrated. When I get frustrated, I get that crinkle on my brow. You get that too? Yeah. So Lulu and Sam glare at each other, which means they're looking at each other really hard. Neither one of them says anything. Then Lulu sputters, "You don't want to do anything I want to do. And you don't want to do what I want," Sam grumbles. So they're both feeling pretty pouty and pretty angry and frustrated because they can't seem to find out what they can do together as a team. Well, Lulu's cheeks were getting hot. She was very frustrated. Why doesn't Sam want to play? She definitely didn't have this problem on the way to the playground when she was Ladybug Girl. It was easy to have fun then. Maybe she could just go play by herself. And then Lulu has a bing idea. She takes a deep breath. She's being a risk taker right now. She takes a big breath and says, "Do you want to play Ladybug Girl with me?" And then Sam asks,
"Ladybug Girl? How do you play that?"
asks Sam. "I'll show you," she says. "Ladybug Girl has superpowers. I can fly and I'm super strong." See, she's showing Sam how strong and how she can fly. This sounds like a fun game. And then Sam says,
"Superpowers?
Ooh, I think she had him at superpowers." And then he asks,
"Who can I be?"
"Well, you sort of look like a bee," says Lulu. And then Sam says,
"A bee? Yeah! A bee can fly! And he'll sting people if they bother him."
That's right.
"I need a stinger."
He needs a stinger. And he sees a stick, and he picks it up and declares, "I'm Bumblebee Boy!" "I'm Bumblebee Boy," Sam declares. And Ladybug Girl says, "And I'm Ladybug Girl! Nothing can stop us!" That's right. They're going to go fight some crime, I think. They're going to go solve some problems. So Ladybug Girl and Bumblebee Boy zoom around the playground looking for help to help anyone in trouble. A squirrel scrambles by Bingo.
"Oh no!"
yells Bumblebee Boy.
"That scary monster's trying to get your dog. He needs your help right away."
Right away. Now, is a squirrel a scary monster?
No.
No, they're pretending. They're using their imagination. And then Bumblebee Boy says,
"We're coming, Bingo!"
says parade. People cheer and throw flowers at them. Looks like these two friends are looking and like, this looks like an interesting game. And it looks like they came on over. Two girls were watching them, and they come over. "Can we play with you?" asks Marley. "I can be Butterfly Girl." "No," says Kiki. "We already decided that I'm Butterfly Girl." "You can be Dragonfly Girl." Ladybug Girl and Bumblebee Boy look at the two girls. "If we're going to play together," says Ladybug Girl, "we don't fight each other." And then Bumblebee Boy says,
"Yeah, we work together to fight bad guys, like that giant snake over there."
Now, is this a giant snake? No, what does that mean?
It's a slide.
It's a twisty slide. But again, they're using their imagination. And Ladybug Girl adds, "And Dragonfly Girl can breathe fire." "Fire?" says Marley. "I'm going to be Dragonfly Girl." Look, everybody's happy. Everybody has a job. Dragonfly Girl breathes fire. And Ladybug Girl yells, "Watch out, you big giant snake. Here comes the Bug Squad. The Bug Team." I like Bug Squad better, though. Don't you? Yeah. Later, when it was time to go, Lou says, "It was fun playing together. And then Sam asks,
"You want to play Bug Squad tomorrow?"
"Definitely, because Ladybug Girl and Bumblebee Boy can do anything." And on the way home, Lulu asks her mom as they walked home, "Bingo." "Mama," asks Lulu as they headed home, "can we get some wings for Bingo?" Oh, I think maybe she wants Bingo to be a part of the Bug Squad. Oh, and look at that. There's Lulu. She's taking a big, giant bubble bath, and she's letting Bingo wear her wings. And what is this white stuff on Bingo's head? Bingo has bubbles on his head. Bingo has bubbles on his head. Bingo has bubbles on his head. And red wings on his back. Woo-hoo! All right. The end. Wasn't that so fun? It's fun adding another character to the series. Tomorrow, stay tuned. We're going to be doing our third book of the Ladybug book series, and this one's going to be all about Bumblebee Boy, the amazing adventures of Bumblebee Boy. It's going to be so great. All right, well, let's go ahead and say goodbye to our Bumblebee Boy, or AKA Producer Knight. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to say goodbye to all of our friends. Goodbye, grown-ups. It's so wonderful to see you, kiddos. We're so happy you joined us, readers. We're glad you came to read. Oh, I hope you join us tomorrow and the rest of the week for the rest of our Ladybug Girl books. Because they're fun, they're fabulous, and hey, you got a red tutu, you have me. And if you ever miss a Miskin story time, please hop on over to our YouTube channel. We've got about 55 videos now, and there's going to be more coming because we're going to be doing this all summer long.